Hello student, welcome to one more video session. This is Vasant Nayak from Canara Engineering College. So in this sessions I am going to start microcontroller and embedded system, a subject for the fourth semester of CS and IS student. The syllabus for the said subject as follows. You can see here there are 5 modules: module 1, module 2, module 3, module 4 and module 5. Module 1 and module 2 deals with the ARM technology. Module 3, 4, 5 deals with the embedded system and its design. So in this session I am going to explain you the introduction to ARM 7 TDM based microcontroller. So in this session I am going to give introduction about ARM7 based microcontroller. So these are the some of the characteristics of ARM7. So first let me brief all the characteristics of this microcontroller. Later I will make video for the separate this concept based on the requirements. The first point is whether ARM7 is a microcontroller or microprocessor. So ARM7 is a microcontroller. It is a 32-bit microcontroller. So if you are new to ARM7 or if you have already studied 8051, then you know 8051 is a 8-bit microcontroller. ARM7 is a 32-bit microcontroller. Means A8051 can process 8 bits of data at a time. ARM7 can process 32 bits of data at a time. Compared to AR8051, ARM7 is 4 times faster than 8051. So that is the comparison between 8-bit microcontroller and 32-bit microcontroller. Now, second point, it has got 32-bit ALU. Now, so second point is it has got 32-bit ALU. What do you mean by ALU? ALU is nothing but arithmetic and logic unit. Here, all the arithmetical operation like addition, subtractions, and logical operation will be carried out. Here the first and second point both are go hand in hand because the microcontroller itself 32-bit. That means because it is a 32-bit microcontroller, it will have always a 32-bit ALU. We'll see now the third point. Third point is it has got 32-bit data bus. You know, data bus is used to transfer data from the memory to the microprocessor. So 32-bit data bus, by using 32-bit data bus, you can transfer 32-bit of data in one clock cycle to the microprocessor or microcontroller from the memory. Now here you need to understand some of the other concept also. So let me explain that with the 8086. We know 8086 is a 16-bit microcontroller. Sorry, 16-bit microprocessor. 8086 is a 16-bit microprocessor. What do you mean by 16-bit microprocessor? It can process 16-bit of data. It can transfer 16-bit data from the memory to the processor in one clock cycle. This 16-bit data are stored in two consecutive locations. So 16-bit data are stored in two consecutive locations in the memory. For example, if this is the memory, then data will be stored like 8-bit data is stored in one location, 8-bit data is one more 8-bit, the rest of the 8-bit data are stored in the other location. But if this data are stored in one chip, then at a time both location cannot be read from the memory. So both location cannot be read from the memory. For this purpose, the data, this address are classified into even bank and odd bank of memory. The data are classified into even bank and odd bank of memory, and the data are stored in even address and odd address of the memory, so that 16-bit data can be read simultaneously at a time from the memory in one clock cycle. So with reference to now ARM7 is a 32-bit microcontroller. That means here data are stored in four chips, one chip is having zeroth location, one more chip is having one location, other chip is having second location, other chip is having third location, so that all the 32-bit data can be read at a simultaneously at a time. But now one question comes, like in 8086, now the question comes, like in 8086, the data are stored in aligned format as well as misaligned format. So now what do you mean by aligned format or misaligned format? So that is, suppose the data, suppose if you take 8086, let me draw here. This is 0th chip, this is even bank and odd bank. So 0th chip, 1, second chip, second location, third location, something like this. So if the data is stored in 0 and 1 with respect to 0th bank and 0th bank and first bank, or even bank and odd bank like this, then it is called aligned data. Suppose the data is stored in this chip and this chip, then the data are called as misaligned data. Misaligned data means it requires two cycles to read the data, because the data are not aligned. It's misaligned. It requires two cycles to read the data, but aligned data requires one cycle to read the data. So now with respect to ARM7 student, if the data are stored in 0, 1, 2, 3, then it can be read simultaneously. Suppose the data are stored in 1, 2, 3, 4, then the data cannot be read in one cycle. Data has to be read in two cycle. So now we need to know whether ARM will support this type of format, like aligned and misaligned. Exactly, ARM7 will not support aligned and misaligned, like misaligned format. ARM7 will support only aligned format. That means whatever data you want to store in with respect to ARM7, you have to store the data in the aligned format. Like the data should be stored with starting memory location 0 or 4 or 8 or 3, that is the multiple of 4. So this leads to the rigid system, ARM provides good performance. So ARM provides good performance because all the data are aligned. So the performance here is guaranteed. But in the case of 8086 and other CISC processor, which supports both aligned data and misaligned data. That means aligned data will take one cycle, misaligned data will two cycles. So here it gives high flexibility, but performance is not good, because performance will suffer because of this flexibility. So this is the difference you should know. What do you mean by aligned data and what do you mean by misaligned data? So as I said, it is a 32-bit microcontroller. It has got 32-bit ALU. And it supports both. It supports only aligned data format. That means the data should be aligned. So it has got. It is a 32-bit microcontroller and 32-bit ALU. It has got 32-bit ALU and 32-bit data bus. So 32-bit data. The advantage of 32-bit database is it can fetch 32-bit instruction at a time. Now next fourth point is the fourth point here. You can see, students, it has 32-bit instruction. This is one of the important point of ARM7, that all the instruction in ARM7, almost all the instruction, 90% of the instructions in ARM7 are 32-bit instructions, student, 32-bit instruction. So if you see 8086, then the size of the instruction, this one in 8086, it varies like 1 byte instruction, 2 byte instruction, 3 byte instruction, 4 byte instruction, but here 5 byte instruction, 6 byte instruction, but here all the instructions are 32 bit instruction. Then what is the use of this one? Student, you see, first of all, it is a 32 bit microcontroller and it has got 32 bit ALU, it has got 32 bit data bus and 32 bit instruction. That means 32 bit instruction can be patched in one clock cycle and can be moved from like memory to the microprocessor. This is the advantage of 32-bit instruction. And when all the instructions, almost all the instructions are 32-bit instructions, it will give very high performance because in 8086 or in CISC related processor, the instruction size varies. It will affect the pipelining process. But here, my dear student, here you have to understand instruction size is 32-bit, all the instructions are 32-bit instruction. This will give very good performance. Next one, the fifth point now, students. Like the fifth point is a 32-bit address bus. So earlier we had discussed 32-bit data bus. Now it has got 32-bit address bus. So what do you mean by 32-bit address bus? So if you have one bit, then how many address locations are possible? Two address locations are possible. If you have 2-bit, 4 address locations are possible. If you have n bit, then 2^n address locations are possible. So if you have 32-bit, I can write 32 like 2^2 into 2^30, or this is 4 GB. That means this will support 4 GB memory. ARM7 TDMI based microcontroller support 4 GB memory locations. It can address 4 GB locations. So the fifth point is, next point is von Neumann model. So this is related to the type of memory used by the processor or microcontroller. So there are two types of model. One is called as a Howard model. Second one is a von Neumann model. Von Neumann model says there is only one memory. There is only one memory which contains both data and code. But Howard model says there is separate memory for data and separate memory for code. Like in Howard model says like there is a separate memory for data and there is a separate memory for code. Same thing is followed in 8051. In 8051, you can see separate memory for data and separate memory for code. But ARM supports von Neumann model. That means von Neumann model means there is a single memory of 4 GB which supports, which contains both data and code. Based on the system, sometimes there will be more data and less code, and or sometimes there is more code and less data. So ARM7 supports von Neumann model. Next one is three stage pipeline. So what is a pipeline? So pipelining means dividing the process of instruction into independent section and overlap it. I repeat, dividing the process of instruction into independent section and overlap it. So in pipelining, normally in 8086 pipelining, we have three stages. One is fetch, second one is decode, and third one is execute. After this process continues, fetch, decode and execute. But in ARM, it will be something like this: fetch, decode, execute, 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 something like this. That means in ARM, first it will fetch the instruction. When the first instruction is in a decode stage, it will fetch the second instruction. When the first instruction is in an execute stage, it will decode the second instruction and it will fetch the third instruction. it will fetch the third instruction. That is, when the first instruction is being executed, second instruction will be in decode stage and the third instruction will be in fetch stage. When the second instruction is being executed, then the third instruction will be decoded. Like this, at simultaneously it works on three instructions. So finally it looks like in ARM, after fetch, decode, execute, later it looks like execute, 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 something, it looks like something like this. So CISC process, you have to remember, my student, here CISC process, in CISC process, because of flexibility, pipeline process will be affected. But in RISC process, because of its rigidness, three-stage pipeline is equivalent to six-stage pipeline of CISC processor. It's a very, very important point here. So three-stage pipeline is equivalent to six-stage pipeline of a CISC processor. So this is about pipeline. Then now we'll move to the eighth point. The eighth point is, you can see here, it has got 37 registers of 32 bit. 37 registers of 32 bit. At any time, 15 registers or 16 registers are available, R0 to R15. So if you take CISC processor has got few registers, like if you take 8086, it has got AX, BX, CX and DX. And most of the time CISC processor work along with register as well as memory. Most of the time it will work both along with the register as well as with the memory. But in case of ARM7, which has got lots of register, 37 registers, and more, and 95% of the time it works only on registers. Suppose if you want to execute anything, load that from memory to register and do the computation, store the result back to the memory. Only two instructions work here on memory is load and store. So load and store are the only two instructions work here. So this is something called as load and store model, load and store model. So this is when one this is very, very important. Like most of the time execution, 90% of the time execution will take place in register itself. And we know registers are inside the processor and they are faster than compared to memory. Only two instructions work on the memory is load and store. So the 10th point is now, which has got seven operating modes. What are those seven operating modes? Student, you will come to know this later, but for the time being, seven operating modes are supervisor, user, system, fast interrupt, interrupt request, normal interrupt, then undefined and abort mode, that is to error mode. So there are seven operating modes, but 90% of the time, your ARM processor will be in user mode only. When you boot the ARM processor, it will go into supervisor mode. Once the booting is complete, it will go back into user mode, and it will remain in the user mode throughout the process, unless and until you call interrupt. So these are the seven operating modes. We have seven interrupts. So seven interrupts are there for seven modes, but seven interrupt will take you to five modes. It is not necessary that seven interrupts will take you to seven modes, because user and system don't require any interrupt. User and system don't require any interrupt. So what are the interrupts? Interrupts are reset, undefined, preset abort, data abort, system abort, IRQ and FRQ. These are the seven interrupts available in the ARM7. The other than that, we have here, it supports three data formats. This is the last one, which supports three data formats. What do you mean by three data formats? As I said, ARM7 is a 32-bit microcontroller. You know, it is a 32-bit microcontroller. It has got 32-bit ALU and 32-bit data bus. Now, suppose if the data size is less than 32-bit, then what will happen? So, ARM supports the data size of ARM supports three data formats. Three data format means it supports 8-bit data. It supports 8-bit data. Normally, 8-bit data is called as a byte. Then 16-bit data and 32-bit data. So, 16-bit data is called as here half-word, and 32-bit data is called as a word. Now the question comes, if you use 8086, in 8086, 16-bit data is called as a word. So, the word has got context based on the size of the processor. That means 8086 can process 16-bit data. That's why the 16-bit is called as word. But ARMS can process 32-bit data at a time. So 32-bit is here, it is called as word. 16-bit is called as a half word. So ARM supports three types of data format. One is 8-bit, that is byte, half word and word. So with this student, I have completed the introduction section of ARM7 TDMI by a base processor. So now I will start with the I will go according to with the university syllabus. So university syllabus, so we'll see that one.